Hi everyone, this could be a very important learning in this video. So we'll learn a few steps in this video. We'll start off with the new unit of measurement concept that the government has introduced. So I'll tell you what it is. For that you will have to first upgrade your Tally to the latest release, which is 6.1, and once you do that, from the gateway of Tally come to display, press D, statutory reports, GST, and you see this map UOM UQC. Okay, just click here. So whatever symbol or whatever units that you have will be displayed here, and what you are required to do is come here, click map to UQC, and for example this is pieces, so just type PCS and press enter. So suppose if you have kgs, you have numbers, etc., so you will type kgs, it will be kilograms. Suppose you have numbers here, you will type NOS. And that way you are expected to tag all these. Okay, so what we'll do, we'll simply tag this and accept. So this is one of the things that we need to do. If we do not do this, then there will be an error shown here. Here it will be an error. Okay, so let me just show you. We'll come to GST, we'll come here. And suppose here I'll type not applicable. Okay, now let's see, display GST, GSTR1, there you go, there is one error. Now press enter and it says the UOM is not mapped to the unit quantity code, so we can map it from here also, which is pieces. Okay, so now we have learned this, and the next step would be to understand how you would get these entries. So when it would classify into a B2B invoice, when it would classify into a B2C large, B2C small, etc., and how we will do the e-return. So the next step would be to understand how B2B invoices are made. So just press enter. We'll see that under these taxable sales there are some three entries, and of these three entries, two are intrastate, that is SGST and CGST are applied, and the third one is an IGST entry. So the first two are within the state. I have simply taken buyer is also in Delhi, and therefore CGST SGST apply, and our company is also from Delhi. Okay, so same for this, but when you come here, the buyer is in Gujarat. Let's check. Buyer is in Gujarat, and IGST applies for the consultancy services. So simply it is reflecting here. Come to B2C large invoice. For B2C large, the condition is that only for IGST would it show under B2C large. Otherwise it would show under B2B itself. So we take another state, say Gujarat, and IGST applies. And please remember, this value has to be more than 2.5 lakhs. Come back. Similarly, for B2C small invoices, irrespective of whatever value you use, that is, there is no such criteria of 3 lakhs. Okay, but this should be of the same state and is unregistered. So just check. This is the same state and is unregistered as shown here. Okay, come back, press enter. Okay, sales taxable, there you go. Fine. So if you want, we can make one more entry and we'll see this. So let me make one more B2C small invoice. So it could be B2C, that means unregistered dealer, control A, and say same thing, consultancy services. It would be 1,000 rupees. Okay, so it has included everything, no problem, because I had marked the inclusive of taxes as yes, which is quite helpful at times. Simply say total value is 1,000. Now let's see how it is reflecting. There you go, this is also reflecting here. Okay, so let's come back and let's see the last nil rated invoice. Okay, so let's come to nil rated invoice, which is a local sales to a registered person. Here what is happening is, suppose I am selling some service or some item which is nil rated or exempted to my same buyer. The moment I select this, I'll give the amount, and here I will select as sales nil rated. That's it. By default, this should be sales rated, sales taxable. However, we have marked it as nil rated sales. So control A, sales nil rated, enter, I accept. Now when I come here, there you go, I come here and resolve it. Tar, sales nil rated, enter, and it's gone. So come back and it shows only here. Okay, so now we have made all the entries. Let's see if I want to create my GSTR1. Now please remember, there are two ways of creating GSTR1. One is the online method, one is the offline method. Now if you have these B2B invoices are small or they are less in number, then I would recommend that you prepare your GSTR1 online only. However, if these B2B invoices are large, it will become very difficult for you to make entries online. Therefore, I recommend the offline method, where you come here, click on e-return, and okay, some of the selected transactions are okay. So I will simply click yes, enter, let it open. Okay, so now this Excel has been generated from Tally, and this is what the report had stated when we clicked on e-return. And let's check. So let us check the B2B invoices first. In B2B invoices, there are three vouchers that have to be exported, and the total value is 10,22,000. So let us press enter and go inside. Okay, so these are the three vouchers. In B2B invoices, please remember, the government wants the detailed invoices. That is, for every invoice, it needs to know what is the transaction. So there should be three such invoices with these details of 11,800, 14,160, 11,80,000 as invoice amounts. So let's check if it's showing here. Okay, these are the invoice values: 11,800, 14,160. I will alt tab and see 14,160, 11,80,000, and 11,80,000. Okay, so this is B2B. Now let's check for what other transactions were made. We'll go back to Tally, press escape, come back. So B2C large, there has to be one invoice. Okay, so we alt tab, come here. B2C large is this tab. There is one invoice of 11,80,000, and the value is 11,80,000, the invoice amount. Similarly, for B2C small invoices, we have two voucher counts, but the government does not want the invoice level details in case of B2C small invoices. So what the government wants is this net value. So let's see, when we come to this here, we come to B2C, it says that for B2C, the total taxable value is 3,847. So which is 3,847. So from Tally, all these formats have been exported successfully. There is one more we can check: nil rated invoices as 1 lakh. So let me show you. If I press enter, it should be under nil rated and under local sales to registered persons. Okay, which is basically intrastate sales. So let's see in this Excel. I'll come to exempt, and that is intrastate supplies to registered persons is 1 lakh. Okay, so whatever report was generated from Tally has been exported successfully into Excel. Just remember one thing: before exporting, just ensure that this is always zero. If there is an error, it will show up here. Okay, so now that our Excel is ready, the next stage is to prepare using the offline utility. So what you need to do is you need to come to this website gst.gov and come to the download section that you can click here and come. Once you click on download, you will see this offline tool and then you see the returns offline tool. So you click here and it can be downloaded from here. So you just click on download and you can simply click on proceed. Okay. So I have already downloaded it. So I will show you the offline utility. It looks like this. And what you need to do is you need to fill in your details to select the tax period, the aggregate turnover in the preceding financial and the turnover for April to June. Yeah. Okay. Then you click on proceed. So when you click on proceed, since the data has already been filled, it is showing like this. So I will click delete all data, click yes, and it is deleted. So let me do. Now I want to import all the files. Okay. So when you click on import files, remember we had exported an Excel file. So what I need to do is, I think it is easier if you have a lot of records to import all the sections in one go. So simply click import Excel and this is where our Excel was. So click here and open. So are you sure you want to save data? Yes. The data has been added. Okay. So let's see, view the summary. So if we choose the CSV format, one by one we will have to do it, but I think this is much easier. B2B, remember we had three invoices. Okay. So if you want, I will. So let's see. These are only the tax values. So if you click here, it will show you those values. Okay. The total invoice values, etc., etc. Yeah. So it is 11,80,000 is my invoice value, 14,160, 11,800. Okay. So this has been imported. So let's check out some other sections, say B2C small. So now remember how many invoices we had there. We have that one invoice of 3,847 and this is the taxation. Similarly, all other have been imported. You click on generate summary, generate the file. So once this generate file is clicked on, a JSON file is saved. So I will click on save. And finally, when everything is done now, what you need to finally do is log in to the gst.gov.in website and then click on return dashboard. Once you click on that, you will see this page where you will have to select the financial year and the return filing period, select July, press search, and then finally you will come to offline upload. So when you come here, you have to click on this choose file and take that JSON file which we had saved previously. So that's it. Once that is done, your work is complete. If there are errors, then itself will throw some pop-up and you will be able to rectify it. But if there are no errors, you will easily be able to submit your form. I hope this will help you in filing GSTR end to end. If there are any queries, please let me know in the comment section. Bye.